So last night I had a little time on my hands and I decided to go through some of my paper pads to see if there are images that I can use to just make simple cards without getting a lot of stamps involved and a lot of supplies. So here we go. I ended up making 10 cards, so I hope you like. For the first card, I start with this DCWV paper pad, and I'm choosing, let's see, oh, this one is kind of cute. So we're gonna cut that out, and I like the sentiment from this paper pad. We'll cut that down and add our sentiment. This pad is from Key & Company, and I had this one for a couple years, but it has some pretty images, and I'm going to use this one. I'm going to cut out some of these flowers. Once I cut out my flowers, I'm using a piece of paper from the paper pad I just shown, and I'm going to cover up. I'm using like scraps of papers. I used that one because I know that the flower was going to cover it, and I'm going to add the next one like so. Then I added one of the happy birthday from the sheet that I cut out at the beginning. And then I'm just using my Copic markers to add some extra shadows to the flowers. And that will be card number two. For card number three, I'm using this pad from Toodlebug, and I love the scene right here with the cats. So we're gonna do our card with that, and we're gonna get a bunch of cards from this paper pad. As you can see, a bunch of images that can be used, and we're gonna use this paper also to add some more color to my card. Then we're going to cut out these few images also from another paper, and I'm going to figure out a way to include them in our card, whether inside or the front. Thank you. So I ended up adding some more lines of images and adding that little kitty cat at the top that's sitting in the teacup. Threes, I believe in threes. Or more than, not an even number, I should say. So I did that, and then at the end of the card, you see that I put the other images on the inside. And then we're just going to use our Copic again to add some shadowing, and that's it for card number three. For the fourth card, I'm using these papers from Motor Scrap, and they have such pretty papers. I wish I could just buy all of them. This one I chose this piece with all the flowers. And again, never leave the paper as is. Add your own shadowing, your whatever, and make your card. We're going to use that same paper pad, and I kind of like this image. Let's see. Ooh, this one is pretty. From the extra that we cut off, well, I cut one of the flowers from it, so I can add it to the top of my card. For the next card, I went through the papers again, and this one caught my eye. Isn't that pretty? So we're gonna use that for our next scene, for our next card. So we add our shadows again, and that's it for our card. This set is also from the same company, and they have such a beautiful papers, I swear. I end up getting like I think three cards from this set. And we're gonna start with this paper right here. This one will be simple. I just cut out that pretty patterned paper right there with the flowers and added it to a pink piece of paper that came from the same pad that looks like watercoloring. And I just add my image, add my shadows, and that's it for this card. Thank you. So these are the 10 cards with sentiment and card bases and everything. And I hope you guys enjoy, and thank you for watching.